In Microsoft 365 Defender, SecureScore assesses and measures your organization's security posture, or how well you're protected from threats, and then provides intelligent guidance and prioritized actions to strengthen your posture and improve your score. On the SecureScore dashboard, you can monitor and improve your score, which you see here in big, bold letters. A higher number means that you've taken more improvement actions. The numbers below that indicate how many points you've achieved of the total possible. These don't indicate the likelihood of a breach. Instead, they offer a good indication of how much you've offset the risk by acting on recommendations. Below your score is a chart that illustrates it over the last 90 days. It's a visual way to quickly tell if you're improving or regressing. Below that is yet another chart that shows the points you've racked up versus the points you can still gain by taking recommended actions in specific categories. To give you a high-level picture of the scope, the Actions to Review section lists the number of recommendations that have recently lost points, or regressed, and the number of improvements remaining for you to act on, plus other interesting data points. There's also a short list of the top improvement actions you can take. These are the prioritized recommendations that'll give your score the biggest bump after adopting them. To see a full list of improvements, select the Improvement Actions tab. For each, you get detail about the score impact, points gained, status, and more. By default, we sort this list by score impact, prioritizing the most impactful changes at the top. But you can group the improvements by category, status, license, and product. And you can also filter the list on the same values, plus a few others. Doing so can help you focus your effort on specific categories, products, etc. Select any improvement action to get more information in the Details side pane. You find a description of the action, its status, and the number of points gained. Over on the Exposed Entities tab, you see a list of the entities, like endpoints, that the improvement action will impact. To easily share this list, you can export it to a CSV file, or you can share the recommendation by copying a link to it, mailing it, posting it to a Microsoft Teams channel, or creating a card in Microsoft Planner. Select Manage in Microsoft 365 Defender to open endpoint recommendations in Vulnerability Management, so you can request remediation in Microsoft Endpoint Manager or create an exception for it, like using a third-party product or accepting the risk. And, oh, by the way, after making a configuration change, don't go looking for an instant bump to your score. It takes about 24 hours to update. Improvement actions for other products will provide different options, so you can open and change the recommended settings, or update their statuses to indicate that you have firm plans to implement them. You accept risk without implementing the improvement actions, and so on. Some statuses require notes, so document the reason for the status in the action plan. Once you've created an action plan for improving your SecureScore, you can go back to the Overview tab and select Include to show the projected score of your planned actions to help with progress tracking and reporting to leadership. You can also show the score possible with your current license and the achievable score with your current license and risk acceptance. The dashboard on the Overview tab shows the most recent changes to your SecureScore, but the History tab shows 90 days of it. The chart at the top helps you visualize changes to your score over time. Below that is a table listing all the activity. Like before, select an item to open the Details side pane, and filter or group the list to focus your effort. Back at the dashboard, the Comparison section shows how your SecureScore compares to other organizations like yours. But you can get far more detailed information on the Metrics and Trends tab. The Comparison trend shows that same comparison, but in a nice chart over a period. The default is 90 days. The Score Changes section shows the total change in points gained or lost over that same period, and the Regression Trend chart shows points you've lost due to configuration, user, or device changes. And last, at the bottom of the page, you see a timeline of the risks you've accepted by points. It's a good idea to check in on these KPIs from time to time to understand how your security posture has evolved. In Microsoft 365 Defender, SecureScore helps you to understand your security posture and how to improve it. For more information, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.